No more mute buttons, no more webcams. This Anchor Duo is finally off that spring semester Zoom, and we will get started with the women and the greatest score in program history.
Top of the morning to you, Owls fans, and a happy St. Patrick's Day. I'm Josh Safran, he's Luke Mely, and yes, gymnastics is searching for its pot of gold, but luck has run out on Temple's two basketball teams.
Now the second half, there is Ty Strickland finding Zach Hicks in the corner. Bang! That gives Temple their first lead in the second half.
Barbone gets a reverse. He's got one man to beat. He jukes him out. He's going to the 20, to the 15, and he gets pushed out of bounds around the 10. A little bit of trickery. And Tom, maybe they heard what I was calling for. A little bit of window dressing.
Ty used those famous Strickland handles and cut in and out of the SMU defense, the tune of a career-high 27 points, en route to Temple's upset victory.
Philly is a basketball town. When we see the kind of effort, the kind of grit that's put forth, we love it because that's who we are, and that's the kind of basketball that we embrace and cheer for. He was coached by John Chaney, and he had the kind of attitude that was not going to allow him to sit no matter what.
Long before his playoff runs in the NBA, Sixth Man of the Year awards, and a college career that saw Aaron McKee start in all 92 games at Temple, maybe odd to think now, the Philly native wasn't always sure Temple wanted him as much as he wanted it.
I was being groomed to be a Temple guy, but I wasn't quite sure if Coach Chaney was there with me. I probably wasn't at the top of the food chain for him at that particular time.
In a year where Allen Iverson was the MVP, Aaron McKee was Sixth Man of the Year, and deservedly so.
Mia Davis is easily the most dominant player we've seen in any sport at this university during my time on campus. So I want to see the two biggest and baddest players face off against each other.
Williams, crossover, pull up from the free throw line, pure, gets it to go. A beautiful play from the Chicago native. Williams it is, he rises up, he shoots, he knocks down the three. Jeremiah Williams forcing the turnover and the bad pass from Dingle. Here come the Owls, and lob in a jam from Jake Forrester. Defense into offense. Spins inside, goes over Dingle, gets it to fall. Damian Dunn can't be stopped.
I've seen some places that claim to be authentic Jamaican food around here. Have you tested that out, and can you give us an official ruling on how authentic that food really is?
I mean, I didn't like it. It was not bad.
Takes a shot, throws it up, and he gets it to fall! Unbelievable play by Damian Dunn!
With an injury list the size of Texas this season, Temple's bench unit became the starters. And when that bench unit just isn't hitting shots with the usual suspects out of commission, there's simply no one left on the bench for Aaron McKee to turn to.
No, yeah, beautifully put, almost poetic there, especially describing Taniki's pitter-patter. Back to that story about Taniki's record breaker, you're behind the camera there. I mean, usually it's people like me, you know? It's people like everyone in the studio, you know? How are you ending up behind the wall?
Favorites against the Rams, and I still took them. Sixers minus 3.5, it was a lock. That's what I get. Serves me right, indeed. Ah, Mike Schmidt, huh? They don't make them like they used to.
And that's a touchdown for the Temple Owls. Temple making it look easy, getting the ball from the 20-yard line and just taking it down the throat of the Seahawks.
That ball's hit well, carrying out to center field, and that ball's out of here! A two-run shot for Brianna Morse, and the Pride brought their hitting shoes today.
For Luke Mely, I'm Josh Safran. Have a great weekend, everybody.